Hey guys, welcome back to my channel Sangeeta's Cakes and More. So today I have brought a recipe on a very young friend's demand. She is my daughter's schoolmate and she demanded me to make white sauce pasta for her. So here is the white sauce pasta which we are making today. So let's start with the ingredients. For the gravy I am taking whole wheat flour, something around 1 full spoon of whole wheat flour. And I have taken 1 complete garlic, out of which I will remove 3 to 4 pods of it, and I'll make paste of it. I will take 2 big spoons of garlic paste. You can take paste. You get paste in the market also. You can take that also. Almost something around 200 ml of milk for the gravy, and I will be making this gravy in olive oil. In olive oil, you can take any other oil, vegetable oil also. And I am taking cheddar cheese of colors. So let's start with it. So let's start with boiling of pasta. You can see I am using a cooker for this. So for this 150 grams of pasta, I'll be taking around 2 to 3 glasses of water. This is boiled water and I am pouring my pasta in it. Simultaneously, I'll pour 1 big spoon of olive oil to it. I'm pouring olive oil to it so that the pasta doesn't stick. And I'll pour around 1 spoon of salt. We'll just make 1 whistle to it. Because this is whole wheat pasta, so it needs a little more time to boil. You can boil it without the cooker also, but it will take much more time. So in 1 whistle, you can switch off the gas. Meanwhile, we'll start with the gravy and saute the vegetables. So let's start saute the vegetables. Meanwhile, 1 whistle is there. I'm switching off the gas of my cooker and I'll leave it for around 3 to 4 minutes in it only. Let the olive oil heat. So meanwhile I'll cut my onions also in a very simple single fold. I have already cut my vegetables, my carrots and beans. I usually use, as I told you, broccoli also, very small florets. So here is my all cut vegetables and I'll take mushrooms also. So now my oil is almost ready. I'll put my garlic to it. Meanwhile, I'll get ready my mushrooms. You can take out these stems and cut them to half. These are button mushrooms. You can even keep them full also. Garlic is sauteed for 10 to 15 seconds now. Now I will put my onions to it and saute them for around 10 seconds. Another 10 to 15 seconds. And then I'll pour my carrots to it. Every vegetable has a cooking time, so as per their cooking time I am doing this. Now the carrots. You don't have to parboil the vegetables. These are seasonal vegetables, so they get cooked very fast. As you can see, I am not using salt yet. Now I am pouring my beans and I'll pour mushrooms at last. If I am using broccoli, I'll take broccoli with garlic because it has a high cooking time, takes much time to cook. See, all my vegetables are almost done. and my flame is low. At the last, I'll be putting this mushrooms without the stems. So my vegetables are done now. You can see them. I'll take them out in a bowl and get ready with the gravy now. So I have taken 1 spoon of olive oil, and this is around 2 spoons of flour. I'll saute it. It will take around 3 to 4 minutes to get nicely roasted. Meanwhile, we will sieve our pasta. This is whole wheat flour, and it takes a little time to get nicely roasted. Now you can see that the color is changed, and I can smell the aroma. Now at this stage, I'll be giving all my garlic paste to this. You might need 1 or 2 spoons of olive oil at this time. You can see you need 1 or 2 spoons of olive oil here, because this garlic is raw and you have to saute it. So now the raw aroma of garlic is gone. Now I'll be pouring a little milk to make a nice consistency. This is again warm milk. Don't use cold milk for this. You might need more milk, but always use lukewarm or warm milk. Never use cold milk. The consistency of the gravy should be this much, thick gravy. As you can see, our gravy is nice and thick. Now I will be adding my vegetables to it, simultaneously my pasta to it. Leave it on sim for a while, as right now my pasta is also warm and the vegetables are also warm. It will take just 1 minute to finalize. At the end, I will be adding oregano flakes and chili flakes. At this stage, I am going to add my chili flakes. That is absolutely your choice as per your taste. And oregano something around 1-1.5 spoon, and very small amount of salt, because we have already poured salt while we cooked our pasta. And at last, I will be pouring a little more milk to it. And now left is my cheddar cheese, black pepper, so my pasta is ready to eat. If you like my recipe, share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to click the bell icon so that you get notification of the new recipes. Stay safe at home. Stay healthy. Thank you.